This is a quick tutorial on some handy track display settings in our graphical viewers. You may know that we embed the viewer into many resources at NCBI, so whether you start in a gene record, the Genome Data Viewer, or in one of our other sequence viewers, these settings can be key to your analyses. Today I'll start in the gene record for human CSK. In the section called Genomic Regions, Transcripts, and Products, you'll see the embedded sequence viewer. If you wanted, you could pop this viewer out into its own tab or window using this helix icon menu. You will likely see the gene tracks in this configuration, where transcript and CDS pairs are merged on a single line, and there is no gene bar. We'll see what a gene bar is shortly. I'll zoom into this region where the coding sequence is, and the first feature that I'll point out today is a new addition to the tooltip information. Mouse over one of the merged rows, and you get a tooltip showing the total CDS length for this transcript and the total protein length. Below that are the mRNA and protein positions that reflect the position of your cursor when you triggered the tooltip. You will not see this position, or the sequence information, if you trigger the tooltip when zoomed out too far. Now let's say you want to see all of the RefSeq transcripts and proteins annotated for this gene. You can go into the Tracks, Configure Tracks menu, and change the settings there, but there is a one-step solution. Just click on this Show All icon at the top of the viewer. Now you see the gene bar in green, the purple mRNA transcripts, and the red protein annotations. And note that this is a toggle switch. Here's another shortcut for changing the rendering options. Mouse over the track name and select the first icon on the left, the gear icon. Now you have the same rendering options menu that we saw in the Tracks Configure Tracks menu, and you may like this other setting, Product Features. By selecting Product Features, you see annotated features on the protein product, such as phosphorylation sites and conserved domains. As you saw, a mouse over gives you a tooltip with more information, such as the source of the feature annotation. That's it for now. Here is a summary of the settings I just covered. The addition of CDS and protein lengths in the tooltips, the Show All shortcut, the shortcut to track rendering options via the gear icon in the Track tooltip, and product features in the Rendering Options menu. We would love to have your feedback. You can use the link in the Help menu, or send that feedback and any questions you may have about any NCBI products via our support center, or by writing into info@ncbi.nlm.nih.gov. We'll be adding more tidbits and short demos like this, so stay tuned to the NCBI NLM YouTube channel, including the playlists NCBI Genome Data Viewer and NCBI Genome Browsers.